I'm a researcher in the Paris Brain Institute.
I'm a neuroradiologist in the Pitié Salpêtrière Hospital in Paris. I'm also a researcher in the Paris Brain Institute.
We just published a paper in GXMed journal entitled Conserve Meningeal Lymphatic Drainage Circuits in Mice and Humans.
The brain and the spinal cord are surrounded by cerebrospinal fluid, which allow to the brain mechanical protection, nutrients, but it also provides waste clearance. Because CSF is continuously produced in the brain by the choroid plexuses, it has to be continuously eliminated from the brain. Experimental data suggests that the CSF outflow collects into the lymphatic system, but it remains unclear where the lymphatic recapture is occurring.
Here we use a 3D image approach in the whole head to compare the architecture of the meningeal lymphatic in mice, in humans. First, in mice, we use a light-sheet fluorescent microscopic imaging after a fluorescent tracer injection in the CSF.
In humans, we use MRI to detect the lymphatic vessels in the dura mater to better discriminate them from the adjacent dura mater and the venous lumen of the dural sinus. We use techniques of vessel wall imaging.
In conclusion, a 3D imaging approach gives us the global architecture of the meningeal lymphatic vessels in mice and humans, and reveal also a conserved interaction between meningeal lymphatic vessels and venous sinuses. Secondly, meningeal lymphatic vessels interact with the perisinusal space, which is the good place to recapture the CSF waste effluent from brain tissue.
In humans, quantitative lymphatic imaging revealed gender specificity of the meningeal lymphatic volume. Men had a higher volume of meningeal lymphatic than women. This feature can explain the vulnerability of women for several neurological disorders, for meningioma, multiple sclerosis.